Good day, everyone. You are welcome to GeojayGIS Solution Channel. We offer services in the services listed on the screen as shown. I am Peter MNJ Adaviruku. Today, I want to show you how to convert raster to vector, how to vectorize data in QGIS. Please remember to subscribe to my channel. Thank you. Let's go to our QGIS interface and load in the data we want to use. To load in the raster data, come to this layer and you see add layer, add raster layer. Then click here to navigate to the folder where it is. It's on in my exercise folder on my desktop, and this is the data I want to use, contamination one. Then click open and click on add. It has been added. Then click close. Now to appreciate this data more, let's go to properties, right click and go to properties. There now is instead of single gray, you can click on single band pseudo color. Then instead of continuous, the mode of display, instead of continuous, let's choose equal interval and click on OK. So for better visualization. So this is the raster we have, and we want to convert it to vector. The advantage of converting it to vector is that if you click here, right click, you'll realize that open attribute table is not here. The attribute table of this raster is not here. In another video, I'll show you how to find create attribute table for raster data. But by the time you vectorize it, convert it to vector, you'll be able to see the attribute table and do calculation in terms of geometry there. Now to convert it to vector, what to do is that you come to raster. Come to raster, you see conversion, then you see polygonize. This polygonize raster to vector. Click on it. When you click on it, input layer will be this layer, the raster we want to convert. Then number of band, band number, just leave it at default as gray. Then the number of fields to create, leave it at default as well. Then click here and save to file. Then just save it in your folder where you want to save it. Let's just call it vectorized. Then here you have to choose the output format. I want to choose a shapefile as my vector format. After that, you click on save, then you click leave other thing at default and click on run. In few seconds it will run. So it has run. Let's now close this, and it has convert. Let's uncheck the raster. So you can see it has converted it to vector. If you zoom in, you see the vector. It has converted it to vector. Now, if you want to confirm, as this vectorized layer is highlighted, click on this select feature and you can select, you see, showing you that it has been converted to vector. So now, another thing that is that if you click here, you can see that open attribute table has been created. Attribute table has been created. If you click here, you will see the DN, which is the layer field we use to do this thing. Now, what you can do now is that you can put it in editing mode, and of course, you can add a new field to calculate area of each of this polygon. You can click a new layer, a new field, and call it, for example, area. And of course, the type, it will be a decimal number, real number. Then let's just make it the length to be 5, and the precision number of decimal places, let's say 2, and we click on OK. So in few seconds, okay, it has been created. Now what to do now is that if you want to calculate the area, you can come here, this field calculator, open field calculator. Then you are updating the existing field, and the field we just created now, which is area, is what you want to calculate. Then after you have done that, you come to geometry. You see geometry here, click here, you see dollar area, this dollar area, double click, and you want to calculate the area. Let me calculate it in kilometer square divided by 1 million. Oh yes, 1 million. In another video, I'll show you all this conversion depending on the units of your map, or of your, the way you set the setup of your QGIS. So you click on OK and it will run. But there is a problem here, because I highlighted this one, That is why it's calculated for only that one. So what to do now is to deselect and rerun the process again. Click here, we are updating existing field and are updating the area. Go to geometry again, geometry, dollar area divided by 1,000,000, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, click on OK. It will run. You can see it has calculated for all the area. So it has calculated for everything. So this is how to convert your vector, I mean raster to vector, and also calculate the area of the vector in QGIS. Please remember to subscribe to this channel. Thank you for watching this video.